Do you know how to choose the right size motor for your racing drone or freestyle quad? What do all the numbers on the side mean? How do you match the props and the frames to the motors? We answer these questions and more. If you live the FPV life, subscribe to our channel to see regular FPV freestyle and drone racing content. The importance of the motors for a racing quad are pretty obvious. They are physically what makes it go. Well, along with the propellers, of course. The type of motor you will need all depends on the rest of your setup. You first need to be able to read the markings on a quad motor. This example is a hobby wing motor. It is a 2207 2450 kV. While that might sound confusing, it is just shorthand for the specs of the motor. If you've ever seen an aeronautical weather report, you'll know just how much pilots love shorthand. It is quite simple once you know what the numbers mean. The first number, without the KV, are the motor measurements. The first two digits are the width of the motor in millimeters. As you can see, this motor is 22 millimeters wide. The next two numbers are the motor height, more accurately, the height of the stators. This one is 7 millimeters. A larger stator generally translates into more torque, which is helpful if you've chosen bigger or heavier props. The number with the KV is the rating of the motor. KV is the number of RPMs per volt that the motor will do. This motor is a 2450 KV. Now this is where many beginners can go wrong. It might seem logical at first glance to desire more KV for more power, but it doesn't work that way for racing quad motors. Using high KV motors with heavier quads and larger props can burn them out. Think about birds for a minute. A hummingbird weighs less than an ounce and flaps its wings hundreds of times per minute. Larger birds have more weight to lift up, but they flap slower. This is similar to racing quad motors. You need to make sure that the KV is matched to the size of the frame you have chosen and the props you intend to use. We'll give you some guidelines later in this video. While these numbers are the most important and usually the most visible, there are a few other specs you should look at when choosing your quad motors. One of these is the current, or amps. Find out the max operating amps for the motors. Also, check to see what the recommended LiPo size is. It is crucial that your ESCs can handle the power requirements of the motors you choose. It is good practice for the ESCs to have a 20 to 25% higher rating than the motors. Always be conscious of weight in your drone builds. Motors that are otherwise identical could vary in weight dramatically. And because this weight is at the outer extremes of your quad, the handling can be affected as well. There are also wide variations in price and quality of motors on the market. Make sure to research brands and models before buying. Now you're asking, so what size motors do I need? Well, the most accurate answer is, it depends. Here are some general guidelines to get you started. As you will see, the prop and frame size help determine the motor size and specs. If you're flying 3-inch props on a small drone, a 1306 size motor with 3000 to 4000 KV would be a good choice. Jumping up to a 4-inch prop, the 1806 size is very popular between 2600 and 3000 KV. A 2204 works well with lightweight 4-inch and 5-inch frames. Going with a larger stator, such as a 2206 to 2208 size, gives you more power for heavier quads in a 5-inch configuration. 2300 to 2600 KV is popular with this size motor. The power and responsiveness will also be something to think about. More torque means faster, harder turns and direction changes. While this has obvious benefits for drone racing, it is generally not desired for FPV freestyle, where smooth transitions are more important than fast times. So above all, make sure your motor choice is right for what you plan to do. Have any questions about motors? Let us know in the comments, or visit the Drone Racing International FPV Facebook group and find a fellow FPV addict that can answer your questions. Don't forget to subscribe to the Dronucopia channel for future drone racing and FPV freestyle content. And stay tuned for exciting announcements coming soon, online contests, and more. And as always, happy flying!